वक्रतुण्ड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम्। वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरो वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ। येनाक्षरसमाम्नायम् अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः। वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम्। ॐ सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। In the last class, we saw a conjunct consonant. We discussed about a conjunct consonant. Can any one of you say, what does it mean?
When two pure consonants are joined together and the vowel, there's no vowel in between.
Yeah.
The vowel comes at the end.
It is not joining. One consonant is followed by another consonant.
Yeah.
It's followed. Yeah. It is followed by another consonant. When a consonant is followed by one or more consonants, that possibility also it is there. It can be followed by one or more consonants. And there is no vowel in between. Without any vowel intervention. That is called conjunct consonant. And you remember the terms what we used? The terms are, I use the term first consonant and last consonant. You remember that? So that is to distinguish the consonants in the conjunction.
Yes, yes.
So I use the term last consonant. These are my terms. Okay. I use the term last consonant to distinguish from the other consonants, other pure consonants. Why I use the definition last consonant? Because the last consonant is followed by the vowel. Therefore, it is written. Therefore that consonant can be pronounced. The last consonant is immediately followed by the vowel. Therefore, the nether stroke, a pure consonant, you know, the pure consonant will have nether stroke. So that will not be there. That is the thing. That is why I use the word last consonant. All the other preceding consonants, they are pure consonants. They have the nether stroke at the bottom. But you won't find the nether stroke. Instead, you will see the consonant is written half. What I mean is, half is, if there is any vertical stroke in the consonant, that vertical stroke will not be there, or the pure consonant in a conjunct consonant, it will be at the top followed by the last consonant, like what you see in the screen, the example, kakara plus ka is there. Kakara is a pure consonant followed by the consonant kakara plus a. There, kakara again, kakara is the last consonant and kakara happens to be the first consonant. Here in the first consonant, that is the kakara, there is no vertical stroke to remove. It's a, therefore, one consonant is written, one is written below the other. So the pure consonant will be at the top and the full consonant means the last consonant, will be at the bottom. So that is one way of writing the consonant, or the other way you can see the half consonant, that is the kakara is written half followed by the full ka is, that is the pure consonant plus the vowel a, that is the last consonant, is written completely. Okay, so these are the terms I use to make you understand. Okay, strictly these are not there in the language. I use last consonant and pure consonants. Pure consonants are those which precede the last consonants. They are written half. Because it is written half, it is not the half consonant. Again, the half consonant is my term. Half consonant I use to show that it's a pure consonant. That is, it is written, it is written without the vertical stroke, if there is vertical stroke in the consonant. If there is no vertical stroke, then that consonant will be at the top. Okay, you understand what I'm saying? Yes.
Yes, G.
Yes,
sir. Yes. Guruji. All these things we discussed. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can always ask. So now you know the definitions, last consonant and the first consonant. I say first consonant because there are only two consonants. Therefore, first consonant and last consonant. Suppose there are more consonants, then first consonant will be there, second consonant, third consonant, fourth consonant, and finally will be the last consonant. Last consonant followed by the vowel. That will be written completely. And all the preceding consonants, the first consonant, second consonant, third consonant, they all will be written half. Okay. Now we will see in detail different combinations. You will see. Okay. I think this slide we have seen in the last class, right? This slide, all the consonants. Have you read this?
Yes.
Yeah, we have read this.
Yes, Chief.
Then the next slide. This we can read today. Kamakshi ji, can you read the first two lines?
Yes, Chief. Ig.
Oh,
in plus a.
It is not ig. Again, it is not ig. When you say ig, you are adding the vowel. It is not e, right? There is no e there.
Ga.
It is not ga also. How do you say it then? It is gakara. It should be
ga.
It should be addressed as gakara, not ga. It's a pure consonant, gakara. Right?
I forgot. Sorry, ji. Gakara plus na in plus a.
Again, you are saying in. It is na. Not in. It is not in. Gakara plus either you say
nakara plus
nakara, or you can say nakara plus a. Okay, listen, you have to say gakara plus nakara plus a or gakara plus na. You have to say either one of these. You cannot say in, you cannot say in. Now in this combination, in this combination, you see gakara has got the vertical stroke. The vertical stroke is there, so it's available for removal. So you remove vertical stroke, simple.
Okay.
And na is written at the bottom. So gna, it is
okay.
Gna.
Gna.
It is not igna, it is gna. Okay.
Gna.
I will write one word, you can read.
Takara plus.
Hold on. I'm going to write sharing some other file.
Oh, okay.
I will write a word, you can read. What is this letter? Right? Followed by, now ga is gakara and can you read now?
Agni.
Good. It is Agni. Can you read now?
Agnihi.
Agnihi. You see now, this is the conjunct consonant, right? Gakara plus Nihi. That is Gakara plus Nihi. Gakara plus Nihi is Nihi. Gakara plus Ni. Gakara plus Ni and it is Gni. Gakara is the vertical stroke is there. Therefore, you can remove the vertical stroke. It is Ga and Ni is written. So you get Ni. And this Gakara, you can see the pure consonant Gakara. In the conjunct consonant, you see the Gakara as without vertical stroke. Both are same, but they are not different.
Okay.
Gakara and this Gakara in the conjunct consonant, both are same. So, in the conjunct consonant, it is written half. This we saw. Gakara is same as this. There's the forms are same. There is no difference. Understand? Now,
Guruji, one small doubt.
Yeah.
Why do we have this practice? Why do we put this gakara in between ni and not a followed by gakara and then ni?
So because it's a pure consonant, therefore it is written like that. There's no other reason.
Okay.
That is the convention.
Okay.
But, thank you. So here in this this conjunct consonant gni. See, this conjunct consonant gni you can pronounce. There is not much difficulty, but there are some conjunct consonant you cannot pronounce independently. It is difficult. That can be pronounced with the help of the preceding vowel in a word. In this word, for example, agni, you take what is the preceding vowel to the conjunct consonant gni? I is there. So now you can say ag and nihi, agnihi. This is how you have to read. So nihi, gni is simple conjunct consonant which you can pronounce. There are some conjunct consonants which you cannot pronounce. In those cases, I'm saying what you have to do is you have to see the preceding vowel. What is the preceding vowel here? So with the vowel, you can pronounce agnihi. Understand? That is how we have to read a conjunct consonant. You understand what I am saying? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So it is agnihi. Okay, I will give another example. This is, what is this consonant? Any one of you can read. What is this consonant?
Pakara.
Pakara
plus
takara plus a.
Pakara plus takara plus a. Now, which is the first consonant?
Pakara.
And which is the last consonant?
Pakara plus a.
Takara.
Takara.
Ta is the last consonant. Takara is the last consonant. Therefore, ta is written completely. As it is written. Now, the first consonant will be written half. There you see the vertical stroke is there in the pakara. So, you can remove that. So after removing the vertical stroke, the pakara will look like this. You can see the screen. The pakara will look like this. Right? Now, can you read this? It's a bit difficult. It is PTA. Right? But whereas now I'm writing a word in the word you would be able to read. The word, this the conjunct consonant will be there, and that you will be able to read without any difficulty. Can you read this now?
Taptaha.
So now you see how you could be able to read this now, because this conjunct consonant is preceded by vowel. What is the vowel? A is there. In takara plus a is there. Therefore, because of the presence of vowel, you are able to pronounce the conjunct consonant in a word. So, taptaha, agnihi, raktaha, sarpaha. Understand? Yes?
Yes.
I'm going at a very slow pace, so if you have any difficulty, you can ask me. And I repeat, because repetition is not a dosha. By repetition only, we learn. So I repeat, that's why. Okay, now, Kamakshiji, you can read the next conjunct consonant which I am sharing. Do you see the screen? Kamakshiji, do you see the screen?
ISG.
Okay.
Shall I read?
Yeah, please read. The next.
First line,
the next right hand side is the combination.
Gakara plus na gna.
That is okay. Now the next on the right hand side.
No.
Yeah, it's okay. Now continue. Read the conjunct consonant on the right hand side.
Gna.
That's okay. That is completed. Next one. Next equation.
Takara plus ma.
Takara plus ma is tma. Tma is also a bit difficult to read. Now I'm writing a word. I'm sharing now the main screen. You can see. I'm writing a word. And try to read that word. Now, takara plus ma is sa. Now, can you read this word?
Okay. Atma.
Atma, right? So now, takara plus ma is atma.
Atma.
Now, this takara plus matma, the conjunct consonant, you can comfortably read with the preceding vowel. Atma, right? Atma. With the vowel, you can read. Okay. Now, the next equation, next line you can read. I'm sharing the file, PowerPoint. Yes, you can read the next. Okay, next person, I will ask next person. Aruna Bhattraji, you can read the next line.
Kakara plus takara plus a the.
See, it is
vakt, like it, as in vakt.
Yeah, kta the. Now you see the form kakara plus the, kakara plus takara plus a. The form looks different. Please note this. This is important to be noted. This combination. I'm writing. Please note. This particular combination, you will find the form like this. Takara, when followed by the consonant, takara, that combination will be like this. Please note this. This is what you will find in the books. The form will be like this. This special form for this combination, you can please note down. Kakara plus ta will be like this. Okay. Ta. For example, I'm writing here a word you can read. Arunavatraji, you can read. It's difficult to try, write in paint. I'm trying my best. So you have to excuse me. Yeah. Can you read?
Rakta.
Raktaha. What is that? Raktaha.
Okay, raktaha. Yeah.
Yeah. So now you raktaha. Note, please, all of you, note this form. Kakara plus ta, it is written like this. Okay, I will write another word you can read. Okay, you can see. Can you read this?
Bhaktaha.
Bhaktaha. Bhaktaha means devotee. Now, read this.
Bhaktihi.
Bhaktihi. Right? So, this is kakara plus takara. That particular combination is written like this. You can note this. Okay. Please note your scribbling pad. This is important. So, you should be able to recognize when you read a word. This combination, if it comes, you should be able to recognize. It is kakara plus takara. Okay. The next equation you can read. Runabhadraji.
Takara plus takara plus a is equal to ta.
Yeah. Now, the first consonant is takara. There is no vertical stroke. Therefore, that is written at the top and the following consonant, that is the last consonant, is written at the bottom. Okay. Okay. Next person now. Nataraji, can you read the third equation?
Yes. Kakara plus sa. Ksha. Ksa. Ksa.
Sa.
Sa.
Okay.
Then,
you kakara see, plus. Kakara plus sa is, kakara already we have seen. It is written half and sa is there. It's the last consonant. So, ksa. Right?
Sir.
Okay. Next equation.
Chakara plus cha is cha.
Chakara plus cha. Yeah. In here, you see one is written at the top, other the last consonant at the bottom. You can write that way, or you can remove the vertical stroke of the first consonant. That is also possible. That is also you can write. In any way you can write. I will show you. Chakara plus that particular combination, you can write one below the other. That is one way of writing it. Right? Another way of writing is the first consonant as vertical stroke is there. So you can remove the vertical stroke and write this is cha. And you can write the last consonant completely. Cha. Okay. Understand, Nataraji?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
The next person now, Rashmiji. You can read the next equation.
Kakara plus kakara plus a ka.
Okay.
Ka.
Vakara. Don't worry. If you can't pronounce, don't worry. You would be able to read it. Read the conjunct consonant. As part of the word, you would be able to read it. So don't worry about it if you can't read now.
Then. Vakara plus yakara plus a.
Yeah. Vya. Yeah. Okay. I will write a word. Vya. There you will see this combination. You try to read. Can you read this?
Kavya.
Again?
Kavya.
Read again.
Kavya.
Kavya.
No, Rashmiji is reading. I'm asking Rashmiji to read. Read again.
Kavya.
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 Kavya. Kavya. Kavya.
Kavya.
Kavya. Okay.
Kavya.
Yes, Kavya.
Ji.
Yes. Then the next person, Vaishnavi ji, you can read the next equation. Vaishnavi ji, you can read the next equation.
Shakara.
Aruna Bhadra ji, you can keep your mic on mute.
Nakara.
Yeah. Yes, please read. Yes.
Shakara plus nakara plus a is equal to shna.
Shakara plus na, it is shna. Shakara plus shna. Na. Here you can, Vaishnavi, somebody is talking behind you there in your house. It will disturb the class. Shakara plus na is, you can see that shakara plus na, that shakara in a conjunct consonant, how it is written. You see, shakara, you can note this also. These are important points to be noted. Shakara plus na. Now the shakara as part of the conjunct consonant, you will see that it is written like this. This is the shakara. Please note this. Shakara is written like this. Again, I'm writing. Okay, sorry. This is shakara and na at the bottom, it is written. So, shna. So, the shakara, you will find in a conjunct consonant like this. This is shakara. You can note this. Shakara plus na is shna. You can write like this or you can write shakara like this also. Both are fine. Shakara, the vertical stroke is removed, then shna. But in the books, you will find this form you will find. So when you see this form,
pronunciation is also same, G, for this?
Pronunciation will not change. Shakara is shakara only, shna only. Pronunciation will not change. Only the form okay. Is different. So this form you can note. Because when you see such form, you should be able to recognize it as shakara. Okay, now I'll write a simple word. You can read. Vaishnavi ji, you can read this word. Can you read this?
Ashwa.
Ashvaha. So now this is shakara plus vaha. Ashvaha. Ashvaha. Ashvaha means horse. Ashvaha. Okay. Fine. Then the next equation you can read, Vaishnavi ji, on the right hand side.
Shakara plus nakara plus a is equal to sna.
Sna. It is sna. Sakara, the vertical stroke, the first consonant is there, the vertical stroke is removed. So you get sna. Okay, good. Now the next person. Kausalya ji, you can read the next equation.
Khakara plus ya, kya.
Khakara plus ya is kya. Good. That khakara, the first consonant, the vertical stroke is removed. Kya. Okay. Then the next equation.
Pakara plus pa. 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 Ipa.
Pakara, yeah, it's a bit difficult to read. Doesn't matter. It is PPA. Pakara is PPA. Pa. Okay. The next person. Gosalej, you can read the next line also. The last equation also you can read.
Okay.
You can read the last.
Pakara plus la.
Na. Can you read
Pakara
again?
Pakara plus lai.
No, can you read
Pakara
the.
Pakara plus na. Hakara plus na.
Hakara plus na is?
Hna.
Hna, okay. This is something important. Please pay attention and you can note this also. This particular combination is very important to be noted. So this combination, you can see, this hakara, the first consonant is hakara, followed by na, nakara, followed by nakara, then it is written like this. That is, nakara is at the is as though at the, you know, at the stomach, in the stomach of hakara. Okay, so how do you pronounce this? The pronunciation. Here the first consonant is akara. Therefore, it should be HNA, right? Hna. It should be HNA, but it is not like that. I tell you, I'll give another example. There, that also you can note. Hakara plus makara. Hakara plus makara. How it is written? This also, that makara is written at the, you will see at the stomach of hakara. There you see makara, right? How do you pronounce this? This also not hma. You can note this. This is also not pronounced as hma, not hma. This both pronunciations are different. Yeah, it is different. I will show with some words. I'll explain this with some words. Now you can note this. Hakara plus na is hna is there, but it is not hna. It is nha. Nha. Similarly, hakara plus ma, makara is there. It is mha. Nha. You can note this. I will explain with some examples. You will understand. Okay. So I need space. So I'm removing this. Okay.
G, one doubt.
Yeah. Yeah, please ask.
That nakara is written at the bottom, right? So it should be pronounced second. That is the last consonant should be pronounced.
I'm going to explain that, I said. I'm going to explain that. So, you can wait for a minute. I'll explain what how it is pronounced. Okay. Now, okay. But before that, I will let me to explain that I need a word. For that word, one more thing I have to explain. So you can see that. Then I will explain how it is, why it is pronounced in the reverse way. Okay. Now you can see. Bakara plus ra, I am writing. Bakara plus ra. This combination, you see that bakara is written as it is. What is the last consonant here?
Repa.
The last consonant, repa, it is written like this. You see the stroke here? That is ra. So now can you read this? How do you read this?
Bra.
Bakara plus ra is bra. Now, similarly, pakara plus ra, how do you write this? Pakara plus ra, how do you read and how do you write?
Pra.
That is the first consonant you write as it is completely, and the last consonant, repa, it is represented by this stroke, pra. Right? Understand? Similarly,
yes.
Makara plus ra. Makara plus ra. How it is written?
Mra.
Mra. That is, the first consonant is written completely, and ra is written by this vertical stroke. Mra. Okay. So now you know bra, pra, mra. Any consonant, now you would be able to read. If the last consonant is ra, repa, then you would be able to write it, you will be able to pronounce it. Now, remember this combination, bra, because I'm going to use this in our example now to explain this akara plus ma. Okay, so bakara plus ra is what? Bra. Remember that. Now, I'm taking the same bra as the example. Bra, and now this hakara and ma is a, can you read this, one of you? How do you read this?
Brahma.
Brahma.
What Brahma. Is it? Brahma or Brahma. Brahma or Brahma or sorry, Brahma.
Brahma.
Can you say it in English? Spell it in English.
Brahma.
So it should be Brahma, right? Brahma. It should be Brahma. That's how it should be pronounced. But in the tradition, in the tradition, it is not even pronounced as Brahma. The correct way is Brahma only. The makara should be pronounced first, and hakara must be pronounced later, even though hakara is at the beginning. Please note this. This particular combination, hakara is the first consonant and makara is the last consonant. But when you pronounce, makara should be pronounced first and hakara later. Therefore, the correct pronunciation is Brahma, B-R-A-M-H-A. Right? That is one way of pronouncing this combination. Brahma. This is word Brahma. Another way is, that is what you will find mostly. That is how the Vedic pandits and all, they pronounced a chant. How they chant?
Ji, the connection is not good. One doubt. So, akara, when the akara comes, the off consonant should be pronounced first. That's it.
Again, I didn't hear properly. Your voice is not clear. Again. You can ask your doubt again. Please ask your doubt again. Kamakshaji.
I'm not able to hear anything.
Can't you hear me? Okay, what about others? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
We can hear you.
Okay, I don't know what is a doubt anyway. So I said,
I have another doubt this, Charya. But when we are writing Brahma in English transliteration, we are writing B-R-A-H-M-A, not B-R-A-H-M-A. Yeah,
but it is written like that, but it is that also not correct actually. Okay. But it in English, they write as it is, B-R-A-H-M-A. But that is not, but when you read, okay. You can write like that, but when you read, you don't read it as Brahma. Okay. You read it as Brahma.
Brahma. That
is, the Hakara also will take the sound of Makara. It is Brahma, as though it is B-R-A-M-M-A. That is how it is read. You don't read it as Brahma. You don't read it as Brahma, but you read it as Brahma. So that is what I was about to tell. And Kamakshiji asked some question, which not here. Again, I repeat what I'm saying. Okay. This particular combination, please listen. Hakara plus Makara. This particular combination, in this particular combination, Makara is read first and then Hakara is read. Okay. So therefore, it should be B-R-A-M-H-A. But in the tradition, when Vedic pandits, when they read, when they chant, what they do is, even the H, B-R-A-M-H-A, the H also will become M, B-R-A-M-M-A. That is how they read, they chant. So, Brahma. Therefore, how you have to read this particular combination is, Brahma, B-R-A-M-M-A. Note this. This is only for this particular.
So that ha is not pronounced?
Ha is not pronounced, exactly. Ha is
so
not
I have a doubt.
Yeah.
Ha is not pronounced, okay.
Ha is not pronounced. Akara is not pronounced. Akara, take the sound of Makara.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Is this for all words or just for this particular word?
For this combination, akara plus makara combination, this is how it is. Akara plus makara and hakara plus nakara also. For akara plus nakara, I'll give an example. Okay. Now I'll give an example for the combination of hakara plus nakara. These are some exceptions. Okay. Exceptions are exceptions that you have to note. You cannot ask why it is like that. This is an exception. This is how it is pronounced. Akara plus nakara combination I'm giving now. Okay, so one of you can read. I'm reading your word now. Can one of you read this?
Madhyanikam.
Yeah.
Madhyanikam.
It is Madhyanikam. So this is Madhya, and this you can see combination of Hakara plus Nakara. So here the Nakara
in Nikam. Madhyanikam.
Hakara plus Nakara. The Hakara also takes the sound of Nakara. Madhyanikam. It is as though it is at akara, as though it takes the sound of nakara. Madhyan nikam. Okay. You can keep your mic in mute. There is some disturbance at your side, Kamakshiji. So this is madhyan nikam. M-A-D-H-Y-A. Madhyan. N-I-K-A-M. Madhyan nikam. The hakara takes the sound of nakara, madhyanikam. Therefore, you have to note this particular combination, that is hakara plus makara or hakara plus makara. In this combination, the last consonant is pronounced first and the first consonant is pronounced later, and further the hakara also pronounced as the last consonant, that is nakara or makara respectively, whatever no, it follows. Whatever the last consonant is, nakara also pronounced as nakara or makara. Okay, so this is an exception. So this exception you have to note. You understand this? All of you, do you follow this? This is this combination. Please note, only for this combination. This is only for this combination. So therefore, Brahma, it is Madhyanikam. B-R-A-M-M-A. It is B-R-A-M-H-A. That becomes B-R-A-M-M-A. And similarly here, Madhyanikam. It is N-H-A becomes N-N-A. Okay. So this is an important thing to be noted. All these are exceptions. Okay, now the next set of things. Who was reading? Kausalya ji, you can read the next equation, which is on the right hand side.
Makara plus lai,
mlai. Mlai, simple. Makara plus lai, mlai. Here also that you can see makara is at the top, written at the top. You can remove the vertical stroke also and write mlai. That way also you can write. Okay. So now, in this slide, the important things what we have to remember is the particular combination, that is kakara plus takara, that particular combination we have seen, that you have to note. And the shakara plus na, the shakara in the conjunct consonant, how it is written, that you have to note. And the third thing is akara followed by nakara or akara followed by makara. That particular combination, how it is written and how it is pronounced, that you have to note. So three things. The new things we have learned today. Please note this. Okay. Because it is written in English B-R-A-H-M-A, it is not Brahma. That is wrong. You can pronounce it as B-R-A-M-H-A. Brahma you can pronounce. Nothing wrong. That also, as I said, the Vedic chanters, they pronounce it as Brahma. That B-R-A-M-M-A only they pronounce. Okay. So these are the things to be noted. Then, the next combination, the next person can read. I have taken, for example, the letter kakara, and kakara with followed by the kakara, and all the vowels are added. So you can try to read.